Quite 1.5 years ago, I released a video called End of Hackintosh with question mark, Apple's switch to ARM. And few days ago, Tim Cook at WWDC 2020 started an earthquake. It happened. It's reality. Apple is switching to their own ARM architecture-based CPUs in their computers. They call it Apple Silicon. So, what does that mean for Hackintosh users? Is this the real end of Hackintosh or not yet? That's what I will try to uncover in this video. But first, if you are new here, my name is Teresa from morgonow.cloud and I do Hackintosh builds since macOS 10.4 version, so it's already more than 15 years. I have all you need for how to build a Hackintosh in my videos on my YouTube channel, so check them out. I also provide personal individual support with Apple Mac, Windows, Linux and server builds. So if you would need any help, just join my website membership. Link is in this video description and I will help you while Skype video call and remote session directly to your computer in front of your eyes. Make sure you click the subscribe button below, hit the bell next to it and choose all notifications so you won't miss any of my future videos. Rumors about the possibility Apple could switch to their own CPUs in Apple computers were flying through internet for a few years already. A lot of people were skeptical about it, but if you will look at performance of latest iPad Pro, it's even more powerful than some MacBook Pros. It's already now faster than 92% of all portable PCs. And it's running on Apple SoC inside. By the way, the developer kit for building new apps for the ARM Apple Silicon is running the same A12 chip as in the iPad Pro, with much less power consumption without any need for fancy cooling. So the whole idea of using Apple Silicon ARM CPUs in their computers is good, and I highly welcome it. People should not fear about lack of performance. It's gonna be powerful enough. Look at, for example, currently most powerful supercomputer called Fukaku. Sorry. It's powered by Numero's 48-core ARM CPUs. Now, let's switch to history, because it's important. macOS 10.5 Leopard was the last system for the PowerPC architecture used in Apple Mac computers before Apple switched to Intel CPUs in 2006. macOS 10.6 Snow Leopard was first Apple's operating system designed for Intel-based Apple computers only. So, what did that mean for users of the old PowerPC architecture? That's analogy with current Intel or Hackintosh users. Well, in fact, quite nothing. The PowerPC macOS 10.5 people could use forever on their older computers, and if they would buy new Intel-powered Mac, they still had the option to run apps designed only for the PowerPC on those new Intel Macs. The macOS 10.6 system was, let's say, dual system. It was equipped with so-called Rosetta compatibility layer, which let you run PowerPC apps on Intel CPUs. And it also introduced so-called universal apps. Those apps were written to run on both platforms, PowerPC and Intel. So, single app capable of running natively on both platforms. Isn't that amazing? Now, guess what? Tim Cook, few days ago on the WWDC 2020, announced the new macOS 11 Big Sur will contain Universal 2 and Rosetta 2. So, the same principle as was used when switching from PowerPC to Intel CPUs. So, the macOS 11 and apps will be running natively on Intel-based Apple computers as well as on the new ones, equipped with Apple Silicon ARM-based CPUs. There's no doubt Apple will one day have full lineup of computers with Apple Silicon inside only. But how long will it take? When? When will be the end of Hackintosh? Tim Cook said clearly, Apple planned to switch all Apple computers to their own ARM-based CPUs in 2 years. So again, does that mean in 2 years the end of Hackintosh will come? No, darling, no. Tim Cook also said two important things. One, Intel-based Macs will continue get support for years to come. And second, Apple is planning to release even more Intel-based Apple computers in future. As always in the past, older Apple computers were supported for a lot of years. Look, for example, at the 2013 Mac Pro. Apple said it's gonna be supported even on the macOS 11 Big Sur. So, computer released in 2013 with originally macOS 10.9 system will be getting support in year even 2021. So it's for 8 years, whole 7 macOS generations. Do you think, let's say, people who invested fortune into the 2019 Mac Pro will be out of luck and without support in just 2 years when Apple will complete the transition to ARM CPUs only? No, of course not. Intel-based CPUs will be still supported for a really lot of years from now. And one more interesting thing was mentioned on the Apple WWDC 2020 conference. Apple is bringing virtualization to macOS 11 Big Sur. People to which I helped with some builds I introduced in my videos know very well how amazing and extremely powerful virtualization can be. In fact, already macOS 10.15 Catalina introduced some virtualization support. That's also big news for people involved in Hackintosh. So there's absolutely no need for panic. Stay calm. Your current Hackintosh builds you will be able to use for a lot of years with full support. Intel-based Macs will be supported again for years. If you plan to build a Hackintosh, okay, just do it. Do it now and fully enjoy it. People often write me, dislikes under my videos are coming from Apple, and also that Apple is switching to ARM CPUs to make building Hackintosh computers impossible. No! First, those dislikes are coming from stupid people from Hackintosh community, and second, in fact, Hackintosh is huge help to Apple. Apple should pay me in gold for what I do for them. Look at it from wider perspective. All people to which I helped to build a Hackintosh are in Apple ecosystem. A lot of Hackintosh users would never buy a Mac, but they are still buying iPhones, iPads, iCloud services, subscriptions, purchases from App Store, and so on, thanks to Hackintosh. So Hackintosh is generating to Apple huge revenue, which they would normally never get. And Hackintosh is also bringing new future real Mac buyers. So, despite Hackintosh builds can be more powerful than the most powerful 2019 Mac Pro for a fraction of a price, it's still good for Apple. By the way, video explaining how I built my world's most fastest and powerful Hackintosh is coming. So if you are interested in that, make sure to click the subscribe button below, hit the bell next to it and choose all notifications so you won't miss any of my future videos. And if you would need any help with Apple Mac, Windows, Linux or server build, you can get my personal individual support, Skype video call and remote session directly to your computer in front of your eyes. Just join my website membership on morgonaut.cloud or patreon.com/morgonaut. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button below. Share this video so it can help to more people. So, that's all for today. See you next time, my Hackintosh friends.